like I just overcame something. There was so much fear before doing that.
Hey yogis, my name is Sky, your host of YJ Tried It, and today I'm going to be talking about my experience trying the Wim Hof Method. I had the opportunity to train with the man, the myth, the legend himself, Wim Hof, at the beginning of January at his training camp in Poland for a documentary that I was producing for a YouTube channel called Yes Theory. If you'd like to see that documentary and what actually happened during our time training with Wim in Poland, then go check it out. I'll put a link in the video description.
We are built to be happy, strong, and healthy. We got all the tools, but they are not awakened. But who is going to wake them up? That's us.
It was one of the best experiences of my life and also one of the most physically and mentally challenging experiences. If you would like to see my personal journey throughout this whole experience, then go check out the video that I posted on my channel about the making of this documentary and really what happened behind the scenes. What I'm going to be diving into today here on Yoga Journal is how the Wim Hof Method actually relates to yoga, specifically the breathing technique of the Wim Hof Method, because I'm sure as yogis, that's what you're probably interested in, is really what is this meditation technique that he uses? What's the breathing technique? How does it all work? And how does it apply to your yoga lifestyle? So first of all, who is Wim Hof if you don't already know who he is? He is the Dutch daredevil who holds several world records for withstanding extreme weather conditions, including the longest ice bath, the longest swim under ice, climbing past the death zone on Mount Everest wearing nothing but shorts, and even running a marathon in the desert without drinking any water. As a yogi and somebody who really loves to practice and explore all sorts of alternative health modalities and healing practices, I couldn't believe what this guy was doing and teaching millions of people around the world to do too. So the Wim Hof Method consists of three parts: meditation and concentration techniques, breathing exercises, and gradual cold exposure. So first of all, let's talk about the meditation and concentration technique that the Wim Hof Method is based on. So it derives from the ancient Tibetan Tuma meditation, which actually is designed to generate heat in the body. Also, part of Wim's moving meditation technique that he teaches is in a horse stance and goddess pose. So you're in a wide-legged sumo squat goddess pose, and you're basically moving your hands back and forth with your breath. And this moving meditation is something that Wim likes to teach before getting into the cold. And we actually did this for 15 minutes straight, completely barefoot in the snow while we were in Poland wearing not much clothing. So if you're somebody who tends to be cold all the time, maybe you're more of a Vata dosha, then this is a technique that would be great to use for you in order to build more heat in the body, especially when you feel really cold and chilly environments. Now, what about the breathing technique? Now, this is Wim's claim to fame. And we know that breath work can have all sorts of physiological and emotional responses. Now, if you go and watch the Yes Theory documentary, Frozen Alive, you will see that myself and Matt, who's also in the video, had very different responses to the breath work. I always get uncontrollable laughter when I do breath work, which you see in the video. And Matt, he had almost an out-of-body exorcist type experience. Now, he doesn't remember any of it happening during that time, but he says that he felt really great after. What is happening during the Wim Hof breathing technique is that basically it's designed to saturate the body with oxygen. So you're intaking more air than you're letting out. You're taking a deep breath in and a quite gentle exhale. And then after 30 inhales and exhales, at the end of your last exhale, you are going to hold your breath for as long as possible until you really feel the need to breathe. And then when you finally feel like you just have to gasp for air, you'll take a deep breath in and hold at the top of the inhale for about 10 to 15 seconds. Now, this is my favorite part of the breathing technique because it feels so expansive through your heart space. This is where I generally feel so much euphoria and expansiveness, and you really can feel it in your body. Like, my heart just cracks open when I do this, and for that, I love it. And at the end of that inhale, you're gonna start the cycle over again. And normally, if you do about 3 to 4 rounds of this breath work, it's a total physiological and mental reset. I use this breathing technique whenever I need to boost my mood. Say I have like a difficult conversation with somebody or I'm feeling kind of like I'm in a funk. I will use this breath work to actually reset my mind and boost my mood and motivate me to continue on with what I need to get done. The important thing to note here is that this breathing technique should always be done in a very safe environment, preferably while you're lying down. Never ever do this in the water. I really love doing this with a group of people. Sometimes one of my friends, Jared, he'll have ice bath nights where we all go over his house, we'll do the breathing technique together and then get in the ice bath outside, which brings me to the next portion of the Wim Hof Method, which is gradual cold exposure. Wim has been subjecting himself to scientific scrutiny since about 2007, when he really wanted to bring what he is doing to the rest of the world and be able to teach other people his method to help them improve their lives. But even aside from the Wim Hof Method, there are several studies that have been conducted that show that cold exposure is really great for boosting the immune system and for decreasing inflammation in the body. For me, the cold exposure is really difficult. I honestly hate the cold, and every time I get into an ice bath, I have to overcome a major mental barrier. But I think that is why it's so beautiful, because every time I do that, I feel like I've accomplished something so big and I feel so proud of myself.
I feel like I overcame something. I feel pumped up about life.
I also get overwhelmed with gratitude after doing an ice bath. I just feel so grateful to be alive. I feel so grateful for the power of my own mind and body, and this is something that I try to do on a regular basis now. So of course, yoga and meditation are such an important part of my daily life and of my self-care routine. And for me, the Wim Hof Method has been such an expansion into this space and offered me so much value in my life and really improved my yoga practice, my meditation practice in a very different way. During my time training with Wim in Poland, he was so adamant about us really finding the power within our own mind and really accessing this inner strength that he believes we all have. And if you have any questions regarding how this relates to your yoga practice, definitely comment below. Make sure you subscribe to Yoga Journal's channel and hit the bell button so you can turn on post notifications and be notified every time we post a new video. Okay, yogis, thank you so much for watching, and I will say to you, the light in me honors and respects the light within you. Namaste. I will see you next time. Bye.